Hello peoples, Digital Mouse here. You may be wondering what it's like to use a mini PC for gaming. In a previous video, I added Bazzite OS to a Z1 Asus Rog Ally and I love the experience. Now I'm going to show you how I installed Bazzite OS on a mini PC, how it worked as a gaming device, and go over the install of Xbox Game Pass and Epic Games. Before we get started, I want to quickly go over the specs of my mini PC. I purchased this Beelink Mini PC from Amazon a little over a year ago. It came with an AMD Ryzen 7 5800H processor. It has an AMD Radeon graphics GPU with 8 cores. This system came with 32GB of RAM and 500GB of storage. It had a Windows operating system installed. I just kept it as a spare PC. Before I installed Bazzite, I upgraded the storage to 2TB using the Samsung 980 Pro SSD. Upgrading the SSD was easy. I removed the 4 screws on the back and the 3 screws holding the fan in place. I removed the old SSD, then installed the new one, and replaced the fan and the back cover. I used my Lenovo Yoga laptop to download the Bazzite ISO. For my hardware, I selected desktop. For desktop environment, I selected KDE, like Steam. I selected AMD for vendor of my primary GPU. And when it asked if I wanted Steam gaming mode, I selected yes. Then I started the download. Once the download was finished, I plugged in a USB drive, and I used Rufus in order to burn the ISO onto the USB. Rufus recognized my USB. I hit select in order to navigate to the Bazzite ISO, which was in my downloads folder. Rufus gave me a warning that all data on my USB would be destroyed, and I just hit OK. Once Rufus finished downloading the ISO onto my USB drive, I plugged it into my Beelink Mini PC and powered it on. I was taken to the Bazzite install screen and selected Install Bazzite Deck. I got a welcome message from Bazzite and selected my language. Under System, I selected Install Destination, then selected my Samsung 2TB SSD as the location where I wanted to install Bazzite. I actually had to do it twice in order for it to work. On my second try, I got a message stating I didn't have enough space. I just selected Reclaim Space. On the next pop-up, I selected Delete All and then Reclaim Space again. Under User Settings, I created a user account using the same info I used when I installed Bazzite onto my Rog Ally. I then pressed Begin Installation in the bottom right corner and started the process of installing Bazzite on my Beelink Mini PC. I still have a lot more to talk about regarding this install, and I can't wait to show you some of the games I played. But if you like this video, hit the subscribe button. It helps the channel. After several minutes, I got a message that Bazzite was successfully installed and I just needed to reboot the system. Eventually, I got a blue screen giving me a list of options, and I just hit Continue Boot. It went back to the original Bazzite install screen, so I just removed my USB and selected Install Bazzite. After several starts and stops, I eventually got into Bazzite desktop mode. Unlike my Rog Ally, from here I was able to connect to my Wi-Fi network and log into my Steam account. Just like with my Rog Ally, whenever I got a message to create a KDE wallet, I just hit Cancel. Bazzite took me to its setup utility tool where I had the option to install a variety of different programs. Again, I only selected Decky Loader and ignored any attempts to create a KDE wallet. When everything was finished, I closed Bazzite's install utility and then selected Return to Gaming Mode. Bazzite exited desktop mode and took me to the Steam installation screen. I selected my language, then the appropriate time zone. I didn't have to connect to my Wi-Fi network, that was already done. After several reboots, I eventually got to the Steam welcome screen. Although I thought I installed a desktop version of the software, I still went through a tutorial on how to use a Steam Deck. But eventually got to my Steam account and I was able to start downloading games. And just like with my Rog Ally, once I connected my PlayStation controller via Bluetooth, I was able to control the entire system with it. I went into settings and adjusted my display resolution. The maximum resolution of my monitor was 2560 by 1440. I set the resolution to 1920 by 1080p. I set it at 120Hz just to see if it would work. To get the audio to work, I had to set it to Radeon High Definition Audio Controller. Okay, let me show you some games. The Beelink Mini PC handled games from Capcom Arcade easily. When I played Elden Ring, my frames per second were in the low 20s. Again, this is without adjusting any of the settings. I did adjust my graphics settings for Helldivers 2, but I was still only able to get my FPS into the teens. And I had similar results when I connected my mini PC to my 47-inch Samsung TV. Let me show you how I installed Epic Games Launcher. I went back into Bazzite's desktop mode. First, I installed an app called Proton Up QT. I found it by going into Discover and typing in the name. I then went into the Installed Compatibility Tools section, selected GE Proton, and installed the latest version. I opened up the Firefox web browser and downloaded the Epic Games Launcher. I opened up Steam on my desktop, went to Add a Game, and selected Add a Non-Steam Game. And I found the Epic Launcher by changing File Type to All Files. I went back into my Steam library and double-clicked on Epic Launcher. I went into Settings and navigated to Properties and Compatibility. I checked Force the Use of a Specific Steam Compatibility Tool, and I selected the latest version of Proton. I went back to my Steam library and hit Play on Epic Installer. I selected Install and allowed it to do its thing. I then went into Dolphin File Manager. I went back into Dolphin and I searched for epicgameslauncher.exe using the following file path. This probably took the longest of the entire install. Once I found epicgameslauncher.exe, I right-clicked on it and copied its location. I went back into my Steam library, and then I right-clicked on the Epic installer. I went into Properties, and first I changed the name of the shortcut to something a little bit more simple. In the target box, I pasted the location of epicgameslauncher.exe that I copied from Dolphin. I pasted it again in the Start field, but then I deleted epicgameslauncher.exe from the end of it. I made sure to add the quotation after Win32. I finished by closing the window, and then I went back into gaming mode. I navigated to Epic Games Launcher and hit Play. Epic Games started and began downloading an update. It installed Epic Games and I logged into my account. Epic Games started and I was able to download some free-to-play games. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to play all the games I downloaded from the Epic Games Launcher. Rocket League worked fine, I was able to play it at 36 FPS, and worked with my PlayStation controller that I connected via Bluetooth. I had the same experience with Warner Bros. Multiverse. It was able to run between 30 and 40 FPS. I was able to play Genshin Impact at about 30 FPS. However, I wasn't able to use my PlayStation controller. I was only able to play using mouse and keyboard. Now I know this seems like a lot of steps in order to install Epic Games. You may want to install Heroic Launcher instead. I installed it on my Asus Rog Ally with Bazzite OS. It gave me a similar experience but took less steps to install. I'll make a separate video about that. To install Xbox Game Pass, I went back into the desktop. I went into Discover and conducted a search for Microsoft Edge. I installed Microsoft Edge. I then went into Applications, found Microsoft Edge again, and added it to my Steam account. Next, I went into Bazzite's terminal, and I typed in the following command. This is supposed to allow you to use controller inputs while in gaming mode. I pressed Enter, then typed in Exit to close the terminal. I went back into Steam and right-clicked on Microsoft Edge. I opened the Properties pop-up. I changed the name of the shortcut from Microsoft Edge to Xbox Cloud Gaming. I went to the Launch Options box, and at the end of the command, I entered the following information. Now, when I first tried to launch Xbox Game Pass after this, it wouldn't work. I had to come back to the screen and place a space in between the quotation mark at the end of the command and the dash at the beginning of the command I entered in. Finally, I went back into Xbox Cloud Gaming in my Steam library, went into Manage, and to Controller Settings. I changed the layout to gamepad with mouse and gyro. I exited desktop mode and went back to gaming mode. I went into my Xbox Cloud shortcut and logged into my Microsoft account. I found that pretty much every game required a subscription to Xbox Game Pass Ultimate in order to play. Game Pass Ultimate is going to run you about $17 a month, but you will be able to play on PC, your console, and on mobile devices like your iPhone and iPad. I was able to use it to play Battlefield 5 in multiplayer mode using my controller, and I was able to get my FPS in the high 50s. I was able to play Fortnite for free, and Fortnite worked really well. I was able to get frame rates of up to 50 FPS. The biggest problem I had with both Epic and Game Pass was getting the controller to work. I would usually have to use my mouse to navigate their home screens. With Game Pass, I found I can get my controller to work by powering it off, then powering it back on. The people over at Bazzite have truly put together, excuse the pun, a game-changing operating system. I left links in the description below for tutorials I used to install Bazzite, Epic, and Xbox Game Pass. I'll see you in the next one.